Hey everybody, welcome to another hobby hangout. I got something very special to show you today. It's called TinkerTurf, and I first saw this at PAX Unplugged 2017, and they released a Kickstarter, and the final product is now coming to backers, and they've sent me a couple of the different sets that you can get. Now I'll have a link to their website and a little bit of the pricing in the description below, but we're also going to be doing a giveaway, so if you comment on this video, then one lucky winner will be given away basically everything I'm going to show you here on the table, one of each of their sets. Now, TinkerTurf is basically cardstock, or really thick cardboard, similar to what you might find in a nice board game, that you're going to punch out, bend a little bit, and glue together. And then it also kind of like disassembles and stuff a little bit, so you can break it down and store it a little bit easier. And now what I'm going to show you is like the abandoned sector art, but they have this same terrain I'm going to show you in a few different kind of art formats. So if you're going for like a particular look and feel, then you can check out on their website and see what they've got. But let's go ahead and jump down and take a look. Okay, so I've got the whole table kind of laid out here. It's much more than I can kind of squeeze into one frame of the camera. But what I've kind of done here is filled up the whole table, and then I've added some little miniatures and things for scale there, just to kind of give you a sense. There's a couple of different Necromunda miniatures over there. Then if we zoom out a little bit over here, you got some vehicles from 40K and some bikers. And then over here, we've got a patriarch there from the Gene Stealer cult. Now what you see here is a bunch of different sets. So kind of the coup de grace set here is this MagLev Rail Depot. It's this giant kind of elevated thing. You can see this actually moves around, this sort of crane type of thing there. And this here is one set. And you can see here these platforms there where the Gene Stealer Patriarch is sitting on there. And you've got different ladders and things on the sides. And then one cool thing they have here are these little kind of, I don't know what these little stands here, you can actually latch these into the ladders. So you just kind of put them there. So if you're in your game, you want to have folks like kind of climb up and then, you know, stay a certain height on these ladders there, then you don't really have to like remember how far up they climbed and so on. Now here you can see a 25 millimeter base, but over to the right of it there, there's also a fellow there on a 32 millimeter base there. And those actually will hold up just fine. These are a little bit wobbly when you get the big bases on there, but any bigger than that, it won't fit. But if you're really caring about ladders, you're usually playing something like Necromunda or Kill Team or something, so the base size should be fine. And then here you can see the platform that comes with that particular set. I'll move those stairs away. They come with another set. So you've got these kind of two sides there to build up, and it's quite the monstrosity on the table. It looks really, really cool. Now, the set that this is kind of connected to, this is kind of an elevation set. And you can see right here, I've got some pieces of it. And then I built kind of a smaller thing and then bridged this up with some stairs. Now, all the pieces, or all the sets, I should say, are sort of compatible with each other. The various heights on the different legs and the stairs and the ladders and stuff, pretty much 80, 90% of the time are going to match up. So you're going to be able to kind of mix and match the different pieces there. And these elevation sets are pretty simple. They're stairs. There's these kind of platforms with the legs and things, and you can do these different heights, and you can pull this stuff apart too and kind of reconfigure it, and I'll show you that more in a second. Now here we've just got some more pieces. You can see I built a very tall tower here with some stairs going down here, then there's a ladder. Now you can even see on the stairs there's actually room for your models to kind of tuck in there, and so they can, you know, go kind of walk part way up the stairs and stay and maybe get a vantage point to attack other characters on the game. Now running through the middle here underneath the depot is actually like a rail, and this is actually a car on there. I've stacked some of these boxes. These come from other sets here, but you can build these little boxes. I'll show you that more in a minute. But it comes with this car and then this track here that has a little bit of a curvy piece. And so you can kind of run this around and then stack different things maybe on this. So maybe a broken down train or something, give something for folks to kind of climb up onto and everything. And then moving over here slightly, we have some of these containers. Now you can see these are sealed off. And they actually sent me two sets of these. Normally you get four of these containers, and you can choose to seal them off or leave an opening or seal one side off and close the other. So maybe this is a place for people to hide, or you can kind of do line of sight all the way through them, however you want to kind of build these. And then over there, you can see I built up a stack of those as well. And then on top of this, you've got some ladders, which I'll zoom in just a little bit on there. You can see that. And then on top is kind of a catwalk. So there's another set called ladders and Catwalks. And so it gives you a whole mess of those. I got some of these spare off to the side there. So you can see here is the Catwalk, and there's different lengths and things to go on. And these, all this stuff is very, very sturdy. And a lot of times you can see here, let's get a closer look. So you can see this is actually, I don't know how you can see, it's kind of indented. There's actually two pieces of cardboard there. So a lot of this stuff will double up and make it extra sturdy. There's no problem holding the weight of the different miniatures and stuff like that. So everything in that you see here, even these containers, there's reinforcements inside that you'll glue in here. And even like these lips here, this top piece here is actually folded in. So a lot of these will have kind of a creased edge that you'll fold in, stick in, and then it'll just add that much more sturdiness to it. Now, in addition to the boxes that I showed you, which you can see more of an example of here, it is, some of the other sets come with boxes, but there's also a cover set that comes with the boxes and then the barricades like so. You can also see tank traps up here. You can get a set of those just to kind of add as like scatter terrain or, you know, for cover and stuff like that. So this kind of stuff, depending on how you kind of mix or match it, will work good for just like a straight 40K or large scale game, and also work for skirmish games like Necromunda and Kill Team and so on. So I did want to talk a little bit about breaking this stuff down. So let's move these cows over here, whoops, and we'll take the staircase off there, and then we've got this platform here. So we can pull this out like so, and then these legs will come out, and these are glued in here, these little like prongs that you're gonna do. And so these are different legs that we can take off, and I put these kind of extenders on there to make this one really tall. So all of this breaks down like so. And then you have, of course, the feet there that these go into to make it sturdy. So I break this whole thing down here into this little pile, which is going to be much easier to store, especially if I organize it. So this whole thing breaks down. This whole thing here will break down. Even this large rail depot, I almost don't want to take it apart, but we can pull this off here. Let's take some folks off of here. And this sucker here will lift this up. This slides off right there like so. And so that's the crane. The crane comes off like that. And then we can pull these top pieces off. Oop, there she goes. And so each of these two top pieces here come off, and the legs will come out of their little feet here. And so we can break this giant monstrosity, which would be impossible to store really, into very, you know, bite-sized pieces and all that kind of stuff. So you can break down a lot of the more intricate things, and especially with these elevated platforms here, again, that allows you to kind of, you know, configure them different ways and all that kind of stuff. So again, I'll have a link to their website and give you a pricing description in the description as well. And again, this is going to be giving away everything, one of everything. I've actually got two sets of the containers on this table, but everything else, there's one set of each. And so if you just leave a comment, we're going to let the contest run for a couple of weeks, and I'll pick somebody. Now, the contest is only open to folks in the continental United States just due to shipping concerns. So if you live in the continental United States, go ahead and leave a comment, and then we'll get this out to you, hopefully to a lucky winner. And I've really enjoyed this, putting together this terrain, I should say, just to give you a little bit of the review perspective. Everything that you see here was very easy to put together, with maybe the exception of these containers. Let's jump him out of there. So the containers were slightly tricky for me, and the only thing that was really tricky about them is if you see the front face here, there's actually a lip that goes inside, and then, gosh, you can't really see, there's some reinforcement floor and ceiling bits that go in here. And so it wasn't like tricky, I just decided to do it a different way than their instructions outlined, and I just found that a little bit easier for me to do. But that was the only thing, was just getting these lips on. I just kind of improvised, and everything looks fine, I think. But they do have instructions, very detailed instructions on like kind of the glue to use and all the different ways you can go about kind of generally building each thing. And then there's specific instructions on all the different sets, specifically and exactly. And I was able to use those no problem at all, like I said, other than the little wrinkle of, you know, the faces on those containers. Everything else went together snap easy. And I really gotta say, like, my favorite set probably is these platform sets, because they're reconfigurable. And, you know, if I had my druthers, you get like three of these sets, and then you can give a whole bunch of different ways. But I mean, this centerpiece here of this rail depot is really cool. It just it just kind of screams a little bit of narrative action, or maybe a focal point to fight over or something like that. Maybe there's some, you know, cargo or something that's the objective for your scenario or something on there. And frankly, I like the containers too. You know, Games Workshop has containers. A lot of people will make containers like this, but for the price on these, and these are just great, like line of sight blockers. Bam, you put it down, and this is cool. You can leave it open or closed, and they just fill up like easily, blocking line of sight. And these look really cool too, because you can kind of see the nice kind of grungy art on this particular style. And again, this is the abandoned sector style. They have three or four different arc styles. And I think you could even mix and match and stuff too. You wouldn't necessarily need to go with one specific art style. And also, I should say, I really like the ladder idea. I've seen this technique here in some other terrain, but it's just really cool. I really like to be able to just, you know, oh, he moved and stopped here, and then we're gonna, you know, put this in there, plug the guy right in. You can see, you know, where he has line of sight and all that stuff, who has line of sight to him, and all that kind of fun stuff. So that's a really cool bit too. So anyway, I definitely recommend the stuff. The price I think is more than reasonable. It's super easy to build, like I said, and you don't have to paint it. It comes like pre-printed, pre-painted. So definitely take a look at the TinkerTurf website and leave a comment if you're in the continental US to possibly win this.